Hi friends, it's Sonia here from Growing Craft, and today we'll be doing this mixed media project altering MDF butterflies and creating this artwork. To start with, I'm going to apply thick coat of gesso on my butterfly. I have taken two different sizes for this project. The design is same, and when I got these already have this red color on it which I was unable to remove, so I thought I'll be working on this only. I had already done first coat of gesso on my bigger butterfly, and I'm going to apply second one now and repeating the same for the smaller one. I'm just trying to make sure that I apply my gesso completely and evenly on the complete surface, and I will let them dry completely. Now I'll be using my memory box stencil to cover up my stencils with the modeling paste, and I'll be doing this for both my butterflies to give it a nice texture. Now I'll be using my foam tape to stick both my butterflies, and I'll be using my adhesive to make sure that it sticks properly. I'm using circular easel embellishments at the center of my artwork, and to speed up the drying process I'm using my heating tool. The fun part begins now. To color up my project, I'll be using shimmer paints and shimmer sprays. I'll be using more of pink and blue and a tinge of purple shade in this. While using the colors, I'll make sure that my first coat has dried out completely so that the color does not smudge, and it's easy for me to highlight my different shades in this. I love giving different depths and levels to my projects, so even before sticking the sentiment, I make sure that I am using my foam tip beneath that. It really makes your project highlighted and highlight the sentiments really well. Like you all know, I love glitters and my projects are really incomplete without glitters. So in this one I had to add glitter to it. I'm just going to put a coat of adhesive on the edges wherever I want it, and I'm going to splash my glitter on it. Now it's time for the final touch up. I'm using the purple shade just to highlight my butterfly, the circle edges, and here and there in the corners. This is just for the highlighting, and my project is ready. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please, if you have any queries, do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you. All the supplies are listed below. Do check. Thank you so much for watching.